So we are talking about today citations and references in your or in our research, and why it is needed and how it can be done. So I'm Professor Khalid Mahmood from University of the Punjab. We have used two words. The one is citation and the other is reference. So in our context, a citation means a specific source. Source means a source of knowledge, source of information, a part of literature. So like a book or article or a video or a website that you mention in the body of your paper. So here paper means your thesis, your article, your proposal, or any kind of your research paper. The word reference means an entry in the list of sources you have cited. So there is always a reference list, normally at the end of the paper. So one entry in that reference list is called a reference. So this is the difference between citation and a reference. So why it is needed? Why to cite others? So there are certain reasons. So first of all, we have to acknowledge or give credit to the work of other people who are seniors to us, who have done their work before us, and we want to show that they have contributed in our research. So in this way, we avoid plagiarism. The plagiarism, you all know that, is a very serious offense in the research writing or scientific writing. So we also want to show our understanding about the topic on which we have written the paper. So in this way, we can show our understanding, show our command on the topic. We want to give supporting evidence to my argument, what we have claimed in our paper, what we have argued in our paper. So we always need some evidence to do that, evidence to support our arguments. And at the end, we want to allow others means our readers, our users, to identify and find out and examine the quality of sources we have used in our paper. So these are the main reasons to cite other work in our papers or our thesis. So the next one, there is in-text citation. In-text means in the paragraphs of our papers. So normally there are two methods. The first one is direct quotation. So this quotation is also called a verbatim quotation or verbatim text. So we just pick a part, a sentence, or a number of sentences from a reading and copy and paste in our paper. So in this way, we have created a duplication copy of the wordings of the author, of the original author. So we have to learn the method to quote directly the verbatim text of others. The other form of giving citation is paraphrasing. So in paraphrasing, we use our words. We have taken the idea of others, idea from others' writings, and we paraphrase or we rephrase in our own words the whole idea, the whole argument. So we also have to learn in this way also. So these are the main two types of in-text citation. So normally, in reference list, usually it is at the end of the document. Usually it is arranged in alphabetical order by the surname of first author, or in some cases it is in a numbered format. So it is according to the sequence of numbers which we have used in the text. So in the reference list we normally provide detailed information about the information sources we have used. So for all these purposes, we need to learn and we need to consult one of the style manuals. Style manual actually is a book or is a guideline to provide us the information and help to give citations and to make reference list and many many other pieces of information helpful for our academic writing. So there are many style manuals, even more than 200, but I have mentioned some of them here in my slide. So the most common in social sciences is APA, made by American Psychological Association. Then in humanities, there is MLA, made by Modern Language Association. Then in humanities again, Chicago style, Chicago, made by Chicago University in the beginning. So Throbian style is also based on Chicago style. So in sciences, there is very common is Harvard referencing system. ASA or American Sociological Association is also common in social sciences. CBE, it is common in life sciences. So it is made by Council of Biology editors. So there are many more, and in our writing we have to follow one of these style manuals. These are also called publication manuals. So resources for citation styles. So in addition to these style manuals, we can find many useful resources on the internet even. For example, there are software packages. The most common are EndNote and Mendeley, etc. So there are many others also, reference managers and others. So there are free citation generators on the internet. The examples are Scriber or EasyBib. We can use indexing databases to have citations and reference list also. So one of the famous example is Google Scholar. So there are many other databases also. They can help us in making citations. So we can also get help from library guides. So there are many library guides searchable on Google on the internet. So it is very easy task nowadays to make a citation or to make a reference list. So there are many free resources on the internet. So we have to decide some points before starting our work. So there are some decisions we have to make. So first of all, we have to decide which type of document we have to make a citation or to make a reference in the reference list. So there are many types. So some of them are book chapter, a journal article, web page, news item, a video or a computer file or an audio file or a manuscript. So there are many types of documents. So first of all, we have to decide about the type of the document which we have to make a citation. Another decision we have to make is the citing elements which we have to take out from the source of information. So there are many citing elements. For example, who is the author or authoring body? What is the date of publication? So it is date, month, and year of publication. What is the title of the work? Title of the work means the title of the article, title of the chapter, etc. What is the edition of the book or any other resource? So who is the publisher? What is the place of publication of that book? So what is the title of the source? So source means the journal or the edited book, etc. So what is the location of information within that source? For example, what is the volume, issue number, pages? So volume, issue number, pages, etc. And at the end, what is the URL or DOI to locate that source on the internet? So these are the citing elements we have to take out from the information sources at the time of their use. So the next decision we have to make is the information from citing elements. So what is the format or the kind of the information we have to take? For example, in the case of author, so whether there is a full name or initials or in inverted form or in the plain or straight form. So in case of publication date, whether we have to mention year or month or date. So in which case only year is sufficient, or in which case the date and month is also compulsory. So in the case of publisher, sometime we have to use the full name, sometime we have to use the part of the name. So these are the information components taken from the information source. Another decision we have to make is the use of abbreviations. So in our citation or in our reference, we have to use some abbreviations. So ED for edition, PP for pages, vol or only V for volumes, so N or NO for number. So there are many others also. So we have to take a decision about the use of abbreviations also. So the next one is the format of citing elements. So format here means that we have to use the title case or sentence case or uppercase or lowercase, and sometimes we have to use the italics or italicization of our text. So for example, in the case of a book, the book title is always given in the italic font. So in the case of the journal article, the title of the journal is always given in the italic case. So this kind of format we have to use. So another decision we have to make before writing our reference list is the order of the citing elements. So an entry in the reference list should normally start with the surname of the author, but sometime if the author is not there, we will have to start our citing element with the title of the article or title of the book. So these were the things we have to decide. Another important decision is the use of punctuation marks. So we have to use punctuation marks in the citations also and in the references also. So period, comma, colon, parenthesis, quotation marks. Sometimes we use double quotation marks, sometimes we use single quotation marks. So these are the common decisions we have to make before citing an element or before making an entry into the reference list. So these are my slides, and in the beginning I wanted to share something, the fundamentals of a reference list or a citation. So in the coming sessions, I hope that our colleagues will tell you the use of endnote and mendeley in detail, inshallah. So thank you very much for giving me an opportunity to share something with you. So thank you, Dr. Sir. It is over to you.